Let's be upfront tonight. Actor Sridevi's death is not an open and shut case, especially after the post-mortem report has concluded. It was an accidental death by drowning. Here is the post-mortem report. Here it says very clearly, accidental drowning. In 24 hours, the cardiac arrest theory that was being floated by those who are close to the Kapoor family has evaporated. Here's what we can confirm. Here's we are picking up as pure speculation. There are two different subheadings. What we can confirm is that the post-mortem report has ruled out cardiac arrest. What is speculated is that Sridevi's blood sample contained traces of alcohol. That's right. It's very, very simple. This is diametrically opposite to what has been suggested. Let's look at point two. The basic facts as being established by the post that the death was due to accidental drowning. That's been confirmed. The evidence is this. In my hand, the post-mortem report which we have accessed. What is being said is that the body was fished out from a bathtub in a hotel room that she was staying in. What is speculated is that the husband had left Dubai but returned for some reason. Many people are suggesting that there was some stress in the relationship, that he had left but returned to placate Sridevi. Was she carrying some pressure? Was she under some distress? That's what is being whispered. Viewers, my first question is, who floated the cardiac arrest theory in the first place and why? For 36 hours, we were told she died of a cardiac arrest. It was a very natural death. No one waited. No one in the inner circle waited for the post-mortem. How can an adult, just think about this, how can an adult who is 5 foot 7 inches tall, and we know that Ms. Sridevi was above average height for a woman in India, how could she fall into a bathtub barely 2 feet deep and drown? What's accidental about drowning? That's another fundamental question. Accidentally drown, especially in a bathtub that is only 2 foot deep. Now these questions have become even more pressing, especially as Times Now has dug deeper and spoken to hotel authorities who have thrown up a very different version of the facts. Here's the big unreported version on India Upfront, the 30-minute mystery broken down. Hotel employee has spoken to Times Now. Sridevi, according to this hotel employee, called for room service at 10:30 p.m. An actor requested mineral water bottle. She said, I want a mineral water bottle. Now these are all versions that are coming out. The waiter apparently brought the water to the room at 10:45 p.m. But when he reached the room, he knocked on the door, got no reply, and he found himself a bit mystified, perturbed. The waiter then summoned other staff. The staff breaks down the door and reportedly enters the room at about 11 p.m. So notice, half an hour has passed between the call and the eventual entry into the room. Sridevi was then found on the bathroom floor. Now this is where this entire narrative begins to diverge from what we were told by those that were close to Sridevi, close to Bonnie Kapoor. We're told that she was found on the bathroom floor, not quite in the bathtub. That the staff detected a pulse on Sridevi, that she was not dead at that point. These unreported versions now raise questions. Was Bonnie Kapoor in the room when Sridevi died? How is it that this theory of Bonnie Kapoor being in the room has emerged? From where? How is there such a wide variation in the versions? The family says She was getting ready to go for a mystery date with her husband, a surprise date, I stand corrected there, who was making up for some perhaps unforeseen fallout. He discovers that she has not emerged from the room after she went up to change. He then goes with the hotel staff and breaks down the room door, finds her in the bathtub. Now how come the hotel staff found the body on the bathroom floor? Why are the staff saying Sridevi had a pulse when we were told that she died pretty much on the spot from a cardiac arrest? So there are these wide variations which throw up the most underlying question tonight. Is this really an open and shut case? Let's throw this open. A panel of lawyers joining us, Simi Chandok, also with us, Simi Chandok, who perhaps has the ear closest to the ground in Bollywood, knows details which perhaps others don't and will not know, is with us on the show. Gaurang Kant is with us, he's a lawyer. Shahzad Poonawalla, Sujay Kantawala, Apsara Reddy, journalist and political spokesperson, also with us, Swapnil Kothari. Now I want to begin first with you, Simi. Do you believe that this was or this is a case that requires no further probe, that we should just shut the file, go home, accept the unfortunate development as being true, or is there reason today to think that we need a probe, we need to get to the bottom of certain facts, because there are certain facts which are being conveniently brushed under the carpet? Simi.
Rahul, you know, you and our team, we've been working on this story since 2:30, since it broke out on Saturday night, and we had all the stars, we woke up a lot of people to get information and to get their reactions. And you know, Karan Johar and Manish Malhotra were two people who were closest to this actress, and they were there. One of them was already back in Bombay and Manish Malhotra was still in Dubai. And I found it rather odd that they were not answering my calls at that time, because I was not asking them to say anything controversial. All I wanted was their reaction, because they were closest to her as friends, and I expected them to say something, that they are in shock or yes, it has happened and it's unfortunate. Because the rest of the industry, when I called up pretty much big Bollywood stars, they all took my calls and they were wide awake when I told them, and they were ready to talk about it. So that kind of got me suspicious over the last 2 days. And you know, then we have the story that Boni Kapoor went back from UP to surprise her. He was here for Manmohan Shetty's birthday apparently. And then there's another story which I cannot confirm, but what I'm also hearing from a lot of sources is that he went and he checked in incognito, which in today's world is a little difficult to do in a hotel at the Emirates. And then we have stories that, you know, there was water under the carpet and that's how he realized it. And then the hotel staff gave this statement that, you know, they had to bang open the door after she asked for water. To me, if you ask me, this looks like something like a Sunanda Pushkar case without any intent of murder. It is very obvious that there was a mix of, you know, seems like there was a mix of antidepressants and alcohol, because that's what kind of alters your survival reflexes, your body balance and your own, vision of how you should be keeping yourself safe.
No, but Simi, are you suggesting she was depressed? What was she depressed about? She had the world at her feet.
And there was some pulse.
She had the world at her feet.
Because you see, she was going through, she was at midlife when a lot of women do get, hormonal changes and they do go through a lot of depression. And don't forget, there was immense pressure on her because her daughter was being launched. And like Jayaprada just said, that she wanted both her daughters to do really well. And she herself was an ambitious lady. She was always on top when it was, when it came to her career. And I think so she must have been going through that stress. And we have also been hearing from Bollywood for many months that there were a lot of financial problems and that Boni Kapoor apparently was under a lot of debt. Not to forget here that the family had a very, very, ostentatious or a very luxurious lifestyle. I'm told that both the daughters, each one of them, had a billing of rupees 10 lakhs just shopping for clothes and accessories every month. So it was becoming more and more difficult for the family to kind of, keep up with these kind of bills. And I think what they
why were they spending? Well, the, are you suggesting there was expenses beyond their means?
Her mother's divorce surgery. Everybody, it's open knowledge in Bollywood. I cannot bring out the account sheets here, but most people in Bollywood knew that Boni Kapoor was going through a bit of a financial problem, and for the daughters to be running bills of 10 lakhs each, it must have been a lot of pressure on that man who was borrowing money apparently month after month after month, and his movies weren't doing well.
Okay, movies weren't doing well.
It is this reason that brought her back to the industry and she got back into her career.
Okay, so there was pressure on her. She basically became...
The last movie he did was Tevar and it didn't do well.
Okay, and she was really then bringing in the money. And that was really perhaps what was weighing on her mind and pushing her towards, pushing herself really. Okay, let's just stay on with me. Stay on with me, Simi, because I need to open this up. Vicky Kapoor.
She must have thought I'm getting married to a guy decades older than me.
Yeah, why? Decades older. Go ahead.
So, you know, she must have thought, okay, here I'm set and I'm financially okay. And then, you know, after 20 years, she realizes the guy is broke. So, it's reason enough to be depressed. We're living in Bollywood where everybody loves luxury. They love fancy bags and they love a fancy lifestyle.
Okay, so there were stresses. So it's not as if she was living the dream. That's what you're saying. So, I mean, that's quite important. That's quite important to know. There were suppressed. There were massive pressures. Now, they might have been suppressed. Some strong people can suppress them. Some strong people can deflect these pressures. Some people then succumb. So there could have been a problem also perhaps between the couple. Okay, we're going to try and go back to Vicky Kapoor. Vicky Kapoor. Who is the executive editor of Khaleej Times. We're going to just connect to him in 30 seconds, but I just want to open this out further. Apsara, ready? This is the issue here. This is not an open and shut case. There are people who had expectations of Sridevi. Perhaps they were, you know, expectations which were extremely unrealistic. Unrealistic. It's an ageist industry. And you can't expect Sridevi suddenly to return and score, you know, box office hits as a young heroine. I mean, it's just not possible. You can't always expect her to look a particular way. You know, we're told that Boni Kapoor really viewed her to great pride in her physical appearance, almost as if she was arm candy. I mean, there are pressures, you see.
Absolutely. I think, first of all, Padmashree Sridevi ji is India's property, and I think everybody needs to know the truth about Sridevi ji. I think 50 years, 5 decades in the industry, she belonged to every household in the South and of course in Bollywood as well. So I feel there should be an inquiry into her death, the mystery behind her death, and of course the pressures of the industry get to a lot of people. Every industry has pressures, Rahul, but I feel she was a doting mother who cared so much about her children. Even in an interview that I did with her, she spoke so much about her children. I don't think she would, kind of self-medicate or OD on anything or do something irresponsible. So if this is not an open and shut case, as it seems, as Simi spoke, so I think there should be a thorough investigation into the death mystery.
There are probable questions and there are probable questions and scenarios. I mean, Gaurang Kant, how do you drown accidentally? Please explain this to me.
Well, you know what, Rahul? When we look at this post-mortem report, we all know
that...
Okay,
one second, Simi. Simi wants to come in.
I'd like to clarify, please.
Yeah.
One second, Rahul. No. Because I haven't said she overdosed on pills, and I would like to clarify that. It could just have been a bad combination of antidepressants and a little bit of alcohol, which has been found in her system. And that, as we all know, is a very lethal combination, and it can make anybody fall, it can make anybody unconscious or die.
Okay, especially if you're tired, if you have a late night, and she'd had a series of late nights. Because she was attending this really high lux wedding. Okay.
And she had been drinking at the wedding, I believe, because my friends who were there at the wedding.
Okay.
So she had been drinking vodka at the wedding.
Vodka, you said, because we had Amar Singh who says that she never drank any hard liquor. She perhaps drank wine. I mean, he didn't explain what exactly she was drinking, but he certainly ruled out Bloody Marys, which contained vodka, I believe. You know, other whiskey, tequila. He listed a whole bunch of, you know, alcohols, hard liquors, which, let's listen to Amar Singh, because He seems to know a lot about Bollywood, and he's sort of in the thick of things there also. Let's listen.
इस तरह के हार्ड ड्रिंक जो स्नायु तंत्रों को बहुत प्रभावित करते हैं उसका सेवन करते नहीं देखा। जिन विवाह शादियों में वाइन चलती है
Wine chalti hai. Now, I think there was another part to this soundbite which we haven't played out, where he goes into the various types of alcohol which he says she never drank. We'll pull that out. But yes, Gauram Kant, I mean, look at what's going on. You have a situation where there are three versions on what should really be an easy to explain case. I mean, if you have had a cardiac arrest, it would come up in every post-mortem report. What comes out is an unnatural death. What comes out, most importantly, is that it was accidental drowning. How does the post-mortem, how does the doctor know if it's accidental drowning or, well,
so Rahul,
something more murky?
When we started this debate, the word used was speculation. What we really see here, when you talk about a post-mortem report, from the prosecution side, we know it very clearly that a prosecution, the post-mortem report could actually contain not only accidental drowning, would have the status of the entire body. The lung, the heart, what she actually
ate. But how do you determine accidental drowning?
So this is too speculative.
How do you say a drowning is accidental or not?
Well, that's exactly my point.
I
mean, that is something which really is subjective to the extent that we really need to see. There can be many scenarios. Scenario one, she slipped. Scenario two, somebody drowned her. Scenario three, maybe she had alcohol. So there are many scenarios which can come into play. But what is important?
No, I'm asking.
From
is
the prosecution
there foul play
side?
Involved here? Come on.
Well,
you know, you're a man
honestly,
who has professional
honestly,
experience.
As a professional, I can say that, you know, it is too early to say whether there's any foul play or not, because the scenario can be very different. If we
so
have the actual post-mortem report, if we actually
why
have
you land
the,
one, why don't
because,
you say, look, this case, just like Apsara Reddy says, we need to have a probe, a thorough probe.
Well,
you
I can't really
say that,
that
oh,
because
well,
there are many
see,
scenarios which needs to be looked
no,
into.
No, what are the scenarios?
The scenario is, what are the circumstances which are there? What exactly had happened that night? What is there in the actual post-mortem report? I can guarantee that there would be a post-mortem report which would be more intrusive to
trace
the sense.
Of, trace
Everything
of alcohol
would
in
be
the
there.
Blood?
We don't really know what was the status of her lung, whether she had any problems. It would actually contain every single detail as far as her body is concerned. So today it is too early to say that.
Too early they say. But we've had cases in the past which have come back horribly misdiagnosed. We had a cardiac arrest angle that was floated for 36 hours. Why was that angle floated for 36 hours, Swapnil Kothari? Is there a cover up here? Doesn't it sound very odd? The family would have been the first to say, we don't know what happened. She just fainted. We found her, you know, we found her lifeless. We took her to the hospital. She never recovered. But they came out and said, cardiac arrest. It's natural. Body's coming back. It's going to happen any moment. We're flying her back in a
Dubai.
Private deck.
Her
death.
Sisters were there with her in Dubai. Her daughter was there with her in Dubai.
Yeah.
How come nobody checked on her for 48 hours? The whole family was
yeah,
with
Rahul.
Her in Dubai.
2 days you're locked up in a hotel room. You don't come out. Swapnil Kothari, this is following a script we've become all too familiar with.
Absolutely, Rahul, this is another Sunanda Pushkar type scenario, and this is a riddle wrapped in a mystery, wrapped in an enigma. And, you know, we are all going, you know, we'll have to go through this Byzantine maze again and again to ensure that the truth comes out.
It's too early to say that, you know, you have not really seen anything.
You know, it's become the favorite pastime of this country.
Then
may
anybody dies,
please, you make
I think let me finish this.
You float theory.
May I finish my
no,
point?
Well, you can't jump down his throat.
You know.
Everyone seems
Rahul.
To be so keen on just brushing this under the carpet. No, look, hang on. There are too many. Look at the, okay, look, let me pull out the version. There are three versions.
Rahul,
no,
Rahul,
I'm not suggesting anything. I'm looking at, look, there's shock after the autopsy, speculation, because there are people who are asking questions, and I'm only echoing those questions. Sarod Khan said, cardiac arrest, believable, but not accidental drowning. No, 1 minute. Sarod Khan, who's a choreographer, One second.
There is no such thing as accidental drowning. I disagree with the gentleman who is saying that everybody wants to come out with theories. The problem
is that the
Put the camera, focus the camera on Shehzad Poonawalla here. Shehzad Poonawalla is wanting to coming into this debate saying that look, you're making a mountain out of a molehill. There's nothing to worry about. This is a natural death. How can it be a natural death when the coroner is himself saying that it's an unnatural death?
No, this is you know, rent a cause Sherlock Holmes jo hai na, ab ye kal ja ke Supreme Court mein PIL dalenge aur bolenge Shri Devi's death is a national interest.
Is there anything wrong?
And therefore they have to investigate.
One second. There are many people today who are asking questions. Please. There is Saroj Khan, the choreographer, knows Sri Devi very, very well. What does she say? Cardiac arrest, perhaps believable, but not accidental drowning. If Sri Devi fell, bathtub water would have spilt out. And she's speaking from experience because it happened with her apparently. Okay. Tasleema Nasreen. Do healthy women accidentally drown in bathtubs?
Finish my point here.
I mean, 1.5 feet of water, even if you lie down, your head won't go under the water. Sri Devi never took hard drinks, only had wine, Amar Singh.
Exactly. Now, I haven't finished.
Suman Sri Raman, DIR Preventive Medicine signed autopsy report withdrawing. Why didn't Director of Forensic Medicine sign the report? Is this report for real? Is this report even for real? Look at this. It is signed Ministry of Health, UAE Preventive Medicine, Sami Wadi, Specialist Public Health. Who is he?
And this doesn't really contain everything in there.
It has been tweeted by the Dubai government and the prosecution has been given.
No, who is he?
Sir, one second.
Who is he?
Have you seen it? One second. Have you seen the tweet of the Dubai government?
And you know the spelling of drowning is D-R-A-W-N-I-N-G, drowning. I mean, this is the casualness with which this entire matter has been approached. We have seen people.
And post-mortem reports are not like this.
Some big fish have gone to Dubai, got into a lot of trouble and got away because they had the right contacts. Swapnil Kothari wants to come in on this.
Are you seriously suggesting that, Rahul?
I don't know.
Let me just make a small point. It's been tweeted by the Dubai government
that the matter
has been forwarded to the Dubai public prosecutor. Let him come to conclusion. You are relying on this Tasleema Nasreen and Amar Singh. I mean, really?
One second.
Really?
One second. One second. There, I'm only saying.
You know
I'm not relying on anyone.
He died in the bathroom.
Excuse me. One second.
Amy Winehouse also died like that.
One second. One second. But they were hardcore drug addicts. You know.
Do you know the history of Sri Devi?
No, no. Please.
You're relying on Amar Singh.
Please. One second. You know.
I mean, first of all, we cannot insult Sri Devi by comparing her to hardcore drug addicts.
Why are you jumping into the conclusion that somebody murdered her?
She is not saying someone murdered her. I'm sorry. Sejad, you probably came in late. She never said that. She never said that. You're being very flippant on this show. I don't know. Maybe you had a drink. I don't know. But you sound extremely flippant on this show. 1 minute. I want to go across to Mr. Kothari. Mr. Kothari, I'm sorry they're not allowing you to speak. Sujay Kantawala also wants to come in. Mr. Kothari, go first. Tell me. You were making
exactly
a point.
Yeah, Rahul, the point that I was trying to make is that the versions that are coming out, the theories that are coming out, the contradictory theories that first of a cardiac arrest and then of an accidental drowning do not complement each other. That is why it opens up a Pandora's box. It begs questions. It begs a probe. That's all I am saying. I am not saying that there is absolutely with certainty that there is foul play. I am saying that there is no certainty with which I can say that it's a natural death and it's an open and shut case. The answer is no. I just want a probe to be conducted. I want it to be investigated, and if the conclusions come through at the later stage that yes, it was a mixture of alcohol and antidepressants and that's why cardiac arrest happens, because I'm not a medical doctor so I do not know, but if that is what the final conclusion is, post-mortem,
why are you drowning him out with your noise? Let him speak. It's underway, the legal proceedings. Why are you jumping the gun? He's entitled to speculate.
I don't understand why people are... people want to brush this under the carpet.
Whenever something like this happens, I get very skeptical. I find it very suspicious. One second. One second. Sujay Kantawala, where do you stand
on
this?
That's why a probe needs to be conducted. What's
exactly.
wrong with it?
A probe needs to be conducted. A full open probe. Full open probe. Sujay Kantawala.
I need about 60. I'll need about 60 seconds. Just give me. Now look. A perfectly healthy woman has died in unnatural circumstances. People don't just generally die like this. Therefore, the autopsy report, which is a post-mortem report conducted by a forensic expert, will reveal if there are any injuries, if there was water in the lungs. The viscera will be examined and all telltale signs, they were standard operating procedure. We need to examine that report because now the matter has gone to the Dubai prosecution service. Therefore, the matter is in court before a magistrate. There will be scrutiny of the documents. So it is very important for us because an Indian national and a person of such high repute and fame, a national icon has died in a foreign country while respecting their local laws.
So we Dubai public prosecutor is looking into it.
Whether it's wrong in that,
if there is nothing, it's a normal Indian national. The rules are the same. It's going through the process. There are other issues that we can focus our energies on. As a lawyer, you can focus your energies on. We don't need to make a khap panchayat and decide whether she was murdered, whether it was unnatural circumstance, whether she did or did not do drugs. Why are we coming into this kangaroo court now?
That is for us to decide. You can focus on what you want,
Sri Devi,
and
all this will come.
Simple.
No, what you are saying is absolutely right. I think the investigating agency would have definitely conducted a post-mortem and they would be
okay, Simi, Simi, I want to ask you, Simi, very, very clearly.
Rahul, I would really like to come in here, you know, when...
No, we need to get in a little deeper.
Yeah.
We need some information here. You've been talking to a lot of sources. This is not...
Of course we do.
This is not...
Of course we do.
This is not a simple case. It's a complex case with many layers. Take us through. Take us through.
Absolutely.
Of course. Because, you know, it, yes. Now, you know, she had her sisters there with her. She had her daughter there with her. Why was she left alone for 48 hours? I mean, today if I had a headache or a migraine, my sister or my brother or my husband, somebody would keep the room key and keep checking on me. Okay, I'm not going to just disappear for 48 hours. If I stayed back to attend an exhibition of my own paintings, I would go out. I wouldn't be moping inside the room for 2 days if I was not well. I would have called a doctor. The hotel would have had some records of a doctor being called in if there was something wrong. So this
what is a direct charge? Better make a direct charge. Why is she beating around the
room? All these people who are opposing this and saying we are reading too much into this.
Ma'am, what is your direct charge?
No, I'm not beating around the bush. I'm saying...
You make a direct charge.
You are opposing that we should...
Who entered the hotel room?
I'm not beating around the
bush. This is not a Bollywood film, ma'am. This is a crime investigation, possibly an investigation into a crime.
Crime?
Okay,
let's... No, no. Shahzad Poonawalla suddenly spins it into a crime.
No.
And you're telling us not to speculate. Come on, sir.
The public prosecutor is looking into it.
Come on.
It will come to a conclusion.
No, you need to listen to me.
There
are certain undisputable facts that are emerging.
It could have been an accidental death.
Yeah, it couldn't have been. Saroj Khan says she was very sure on her feet. Not the type of person who could teeter over, fall, especially into a tub which is 3 foot long and has about a foot and a half of water. That's about that much water.
She's 5'8", you know, and she's not the thinnest lady in the world.
Yeah, exactly. It's not easy.
Relying on Saroj Khan's statement and expertise, really. Of no, Saroj Khan's expertise is what you're
speaking as somebody who knows Ms. Sri Devi.
Saroj
why
Khan
do we discount
no
it? Why are you so sore on the cardiac arrest theory? There
I'm
have been individuals in the past
in the newspapers and the media
that brushed under the carpet.
Has it been ruled out?
Has it been ruled out? The cause of her consciousness?
Has it been ruled out?
I don't understand why this gentleman is getting stuck to cardiac.
I don't know.
I have not said cardiac even once. I am saying let it be investigated by the right authorities. Yahan pe khaap panchayat mat banao.
When you say it's a criminal investigation, it's a crime investigation.
Why is it abolition? How are you jumping to these conclusions? It's insulting to their family, which needs to grieve and mourn. We are sitting here thinking of the circumstances between Bonny and Sridevi. That's not insulting to Sridevi.
In fact, the family should be more interested.
You did that to other people in Jadroya and you're doing it to these people now.
Anil, I think you just love the sound of your own voice. I mean, there are other people who want to get a word as ways. You're just blathering on and on and on like a broken record. One second. Mr. Poonawala, relax. You're not the only one who knows the law here. There are other people who have a point of view and they are expressing.
We still don't know what happened.
Now she's gone to Divya Bharti.
One second, these are facts. Do you know?
Sir, I have no answer to what the Divya Bharti is circumstantial death. Then why is she not the greatest ever before?
Give me 30 seconds, it's not funny anymore. Please, it's not funny anymore. Please.
It is, I mean Divya Bharti is not
funny. It's not funny. Someone has died. There are people. There are people who care a great deal about Ms. Sridevi. She's passed away. They want to know what has happened. They want to hear from the media what has happened. We are getting received information from a second-hand source, which is the Emirates government. No one is holding regular briefings. No one is giving you a medical update. No doctor, except for some peculiar, very rudimentary, very badly spelt, constructed post-mortem report. And it is being issued by the Director of Preventive Medicine, Dubai. Not even the head of forensic analysis. And if you would ring up, they would say, no, we don't even have a department. So then they should release the body. They should allow for others to conduct forensic tests or perhaps release it to a private hospital. I refuse to believe, Swapnil Kothari, that there are no forensic departments in this particular hotel, in the Ministry of Health, that they can't refer to.
Yes, absolutely, Rahul, you've asked a very pertinent question, and it stands to reason that when this case goes to the Dubai prosecution, when it's been handed over to them, that means that there is some doubt, even if it's an iota of doubt or a shred of suspicion, which is there in the minds of the authorities that this is not an open and shut case, and this does not seem to be, let me word phrase myself that way for all the people who seem to have some aberration or some great umbrage at the fact that I'm asking for a probe. I do not understand that why do I have to stick to a cardiac arrest theory just because they believe in it? I am entitled to believe in something which is opposite. It may be the opposite view of the spectrum. I could be completely wrong at the end of the day. It doesn't really matter. But the fact to say that tomorrow I'm going to go to
Arif joins me from Dubai. Arif is our correspondent reporting on the ground from Dubai with the only channel with a link straight up to Dubai. I want to go across to him. Arif, you're where the body is, I believe. What are you hearing?
Right now body is still with the police forensic department, and some Indian officials and other Indian fans of Sridevi are still waiting the body of Sridevi, the superstar who died on Saturday night here in Dubai. They are waiting right now in embalming unit where the body will be shifted from forensic department. But the police says, our sources is saying that there is still a time to repatriate the body from the forensic department to amalgam unit, and then from amalgam unit after 15 or 16 minutes procedure here, they will transfer the body from Al Maktoum Airport, and the body will be shifted by air from Al Maktoum Airport, Dubai to Mumbai. But it will take so much time because police is not certain yet. The final proceeding is still going on, and the Indian officials are also waiting here
Are we going to hear from the doctors who've conducted this autopsy? Are they going to address a press conference? Because there are several questions, and they are being asked by people who are shattered. Their hearts are broken and they wonder how this could happen, how there can be so many disparities. Arif.
Yes, definitely. There are so much hue and cry about the repatriation of the body. But, you know, if legal system in Dubai is like that, if someone receives that by the hospital, then it will take time to be investigated properly. So police is investigating. No press conference to be held here because in Dubai or other Middle Eastern countries, normally police don't hold press conferences. But Dubai government department Twitter handle tweeted almost 2 hours ago that
we're being told, Arif, that this is big news. This is big news that the public prosecutor is not convinced by the forensic report.
Yes, definitely, definitely. Public prosecutor is not convinced by the report. That's why they are doing some more investigating regarding this.
Wait a minute. This is very big.
Death of the demise.
Massive, massive twist. This is big breaking news. Big breaking news. The public prosecutor is not convinced with the forensic report, and quite frankly, I won't be either. Look at the spellings on this, and I'm taking a very superficial view. Yes, you can make a few grammatical errors, but this is so sketchy. It begs the question, even if an autopsy was conducted with any intent to get to the truth, where is the Visra report? Where is the report of the blood? The vascular system report, if there was a cardiac arrest, what triggered Ms. Sridevi to fall over into a bathtub? Arif, is anyone going to answer these questions?
The answer is going to be asked by Dubai police, and police, Dubai police are also investigating on these questions that and try to find the main cause of death of superstar here in Dubai. That's why they are investigating. That's why they are the cordon of the room of where the Sridevi had been staying, and now they are getting CCTV footage of the corridors of that hotel, Jumeirah Emirates Hotel, and different aspects, different angles are there from where the Dubai police is still investigating and try to find the truth behind the death of the superstar.
So you're saying that there's a possibility that Bonnie Kapoor and others might just be further questioned by the police. That's what you're saying. The investigation is not over.
Not really, but already the hospital from where the Sridevi's body was received at Rashid Hospital. They already asked some questions and got the medical history of Sridevi here. And police, if they think currently they are not investigating from any relative, but it might be possible they will ask and invite some police or some relatives from Sridevi to ask some questions.
We are being told that CCTV footage has been sought by the prosecutors. They believe that there's a lot more to this entire episode, this very tragic episode that has transpired over the last 36 hours. I want to go straight back to Sujay Kantawala and also Mr. Kothari. Sujay Kantawala first, the public prosecutor not satisfied. What does that mean? And do you have any knowledge of how the law works, really? The process, the procedure? We have a CRPC here,
yes.
We have a...
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you just illuminate us?
That's right. So I'll tell you. The public prosecutor is the person who represents the police before the court. He has to answer the court's questions. When he himself is not satisfied that this is not done properly, or he smells a rat with his experience, he can always ask for a second post-mortem to be done and the standard operating procedures to be followed. The viscera, which is the most important organ, will have to be preserved and will have to be checked for its contents. If there was traces of alcohol, then what type of alcohol was there? If there was water which had filled up in the lungs, then why? And how long did the body remain submerged in the water? Apart from that, the CCTV footage, as you rightly said, will have to be examined.
Everything will have to be seen now, because now this is getting little murky, and therefore one has to see from all angles, because a foreign national has died in their country, and if they sleep over it, and if they don't go and probe deep into this, now that the prosecutor has shown that there is something else rather than the initial theory of cardiac arrest or whatever was floated. Now it will be very interesting to see how they proceed further in the matter.
Please tell me where
and
has he
which people
this?
Are picked up.
One second, I don't know, Mr. Kandawala speaking about legal facts goes into his own fiction. I have a tweet of the Dubai media office. Case has been transferred from Dubai police to Dubai public prosecution, which will carry out legal procedures. Whereas the Dubai public prosecution's comment told Kandawala in his ears that there is something amiss. I mean, why are you going a step ahead?
This is my problem. You should have heard the comment from Dubai. You should have heard the comment from Dubai.
They have not said what is the cause of loss of consciousness. One second, sir. One second. Why are you saying 48 hours, where was Bonny Kapoor? Where was this? Where was that?
What is all this?
He might have spoken to somebody.
Simi, and why are you opposing everything? Why are you opposing everything?
Simi, I saw you looking at your phone. Have you got an update? Simi, tell me. Have you got an update? I saw you looking at your phone.
Yes, actually, you know what I've heard, that you know they first initially tried to get away with this whole theory of the cardiac arrest, and they tried to pull in like, you know, some of the connections there. That's and right. There is a very popular guy amongst the film circles called Rajat Rawal, and another person was called, and when they could not get away with the cardiac story is when they called the police, is when Bonny Kapoor decided to allegedly call the police and say, okay, this is what has happened, and then this other
the
theory
time.
Came in that she has fallen in
yeah,
the
there was a massive lag between when
so
they, when the medics were called and when the police was informed.
Kind of shut this cardiac arrest
right.
story right there and then.
That's right.
Okay, so there was this massive lag. Why would there have been a lag, Gauram Khan?
Any story being put by Bonny Kapoor or the family will not be that convincing.
No, why was there a lag between the medics attending to Sridevi, whether she was alive, she had a pulse or not, I can't say.
Well, we have to really figure it out.
About
how long was the lag?
2 hours,
because, you know,
2-3 hours.
That's a fact.
2-3 hours, yes, it's
then,
a fact.
That's
what,
look,
I mean,
question.
It's a fact only because that's the story that is being put out
well,
by the Bonny Kapoor camp. Now, I don't know. I don't know what the facts are, but why would they put out a fact which would come back perhaps as a question to haunt them? So I would expect them
exactly.
to have
You're
actually...
Exactly, you're answering your own question.
No, I'm not.
Maybe
I'm just saying.
So
no, one second.
Things.
So somebody has said, somebody in the group who came up with this big cardiac arrest, and I think you've got to give Simi... You've got to give Simi the fact that she has actually spoken to a lot of people. True. And you know, you might have pulled the blinkers over your eyes, Shehzad Poonawalla, but sometimes you've got to keep your ears open to new information. Now I'm asking you, Gauram Khan, it's a very simple, straightforward question.
The entire Times Now team hasn't slept in 3 nights now.
I know, but I'm just going to ask you very, very simply,
no,
Gauram Khan,
sure
if the public prosecutor
so
is the public prosecutor, we put it out. We put it out in the motion.
You should not.
It's a well-known fact.
Is not, we,
no,
we
no, one second, one second, one second. You know, facts emerge.
So then
let's
why
not be too clever about
it. Shehzad
Poonawalla, let's not be too clever about it.
Why are blaming Gauram Khan?
I'm asking you. You have a situation here where the public prosecutor spins around and says, I do not accept the forensic report. Now, Shehzad Poonawalla says it's been tweeted by
right.
the authorities, so you must take it as gospel truth. We know
tweeted.
In this country several times.
No, but
reports are no. Lamb becomes beef, beef becomes goat, goat becomes horse, horse becomes dog. We know how that happens.
Well, absolutely. But then what I want to point it out that this is not
this is the same Shehzad Poonawalla who had a problem with lamb becoming beef and beef becoming lamb.
No,
I'm
are you suggesting that
you had a problem.
Are you suggesting
that trying to suggest that you see everyone else has got this wrong, that they don't have any reason to feel suspicious.
Don't forget that you have questioned forensic experts.
Why not? Who is the Dubai expert? Are they my government? They're not my government. I don't trust them. What is wrong?
You don't trust them.
This is the same government that Harbour Dawood Ibrahim for years
got together.
Now one
minute.
We will
do the investigation.
Gauram Khan.
You tell them that.
We know the leaky legal framework in the Emirates. We know. So there is citizenship there, they do business, and then when it becomes inconvenient, they quietly sneaked out either into Saudi Arabia or Pakistan. We know how it works
so
in the UAE.
Authorities to get the body here and we will do the investigation.
As far as the prosecution is concerned, they are not really involved with the investigation. That is something which they are going to appreciate the evidence which is
Charu Khanna, Charu Khanna, Mumbai. Go ahead, Charu. Go ahead with your views.
Yeah, hi. This is Charu here from Mumbai.
Good evening.
Good evening. To my opinion, the report doesn't look very professional. Reason being, there's a spelling error. And that's not the way reports are, you know, framed.
Yeah.
Secondly, initially the report said that it was Boni Kapoor who landed in Dubai.
Yes.
And he was the one who woke Sridevi. She was, it seems, sleeping. That was around 5:30 in the evening.
Yeah.
And they chatted for about 15 minutes, post which they decided to get ready and leave for dinner. And now what's flashing on news channels is that she requested for water at 10:30.
Yes. It's all confusing. I'm as bewildered as you are. I think we need a probe, and that's why we said it's not an open and shut case. Pallav Bhattacharya. Pallav Bhattacharya calling in from Pune. Yeah. Go ahead, Pallav.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Very clearly. One second. Pallav Bhattacharya coming in. Yes.
Yeah. I just want to agree with the gentleman in the middle. He mentioned that, you know, we don't have to agree with this suicide, or sorry, with this cardiac arrest theory that they're putting in. We need it to be, you know, investigated. It's not that we are not being sensitive to the family. But there has been a tragedy. There is this whole cardiac arrest is not, you know, it's not holding water.
Yeah.
And I agree with you that we need investigation there.
Absolutely. Pallav, thank you for calling in. Sharad calling in from Kolkata. Viewers are skeptical. Shahzad Poonawala, viewers are skeptical.
They are bound to be skeptical.
They are not. They are bound to be. Perhaps as you are, I don't know.
I am not.
Or maybe you are just selective.
The authorities.
Okay. Sharad calling in. Don't change your line. Yes. Sharad calling in from Kolkata. Good evening.
Yeah, Sharad from Kolkata.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. I'm feeling it's very strange that why a media postmortem is going on for a legend at the TV channel. Let Dubai police do the needful and then you can discuss this. Unless there is a media trial, postmortem is going on there. It's absolutely rubbish.
Okay, you should fair not point. Do it. Fair one point. There are viewers. There are viewers who are going to have...
People are...
Yes, absolutely, sir. Viewers are going to have different views. We are open to them. People are skeptical. There are also some believers who say, let's wait. But it's interesting. Sharad says, let's not jump to a conclusion. No one is jumping to a conclusion. We're only saying, and the question is very clear. It's at the bottom. No one is hanging anybody. We're just saying it's a mystery and an investigation should be done. It should be done. There should be a deeper probe. Selvida, Mauritius. Selvida from Mauritius. Selvida.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, ma'am. Go ahead.
Yes, I'm calling from Mauritius and I've seen the death certificate of Sridevi ji, it's really like lots of mistakes are there and it's such a simple death certificate.
I know.
And I've seen an original certificate but I don't understand why it's just a simple certificate.
Okay, Ahmed Patel. M.R. Patel from Ahmednagar. M.R. Patel,
Ahmed Patel, Patil. Mr. Patil, Public Prosecutor, Ahmednagar, Maharashtra.
Right, sir. Good evening. Sorry I got that wrong.
Sir, that is a simple question. When the cause of death is only, given by the Dubai authority, number one. What is the internal injury? What is the external injury? What are the symptoms of the cause of death is not finalized, number one. Number two, when accidental death is registered, thereafter, if the investigating authority or any complainant is doubt, number one, when there is a doubt, then the after accidental death investigation is in progress. And if they satisfy that it is an accidental death, the matter is closed.
Gee.
If they are not satisfied, thereafter offense is registered. That is a settled law, criminal settled law. Number one. Number two, what is my humble submission before these spokespersons? They don't know every study of the law and they are speaking like a...
I know. Patil sir, you know, look, everyone has an opinion. Everyone has an opinion and we must not proscribe anyone's opinion. I respect your opinion. I respected the previous viewer's opinion. Sharad calling in from Kolkata who said it's all rubbish. Get on with your life. Get on with your day. focus on other important stories. There will be many people who will even say nine children have died today.
That's true.
In a pocket of, we are not actually today but 3 days ago, and there's been no arrest, and we should be actually focusing on that story. Well,
very tragic.
Well,
very tragic.
I have no answers for them. I can only say we're doing it at 10 o'clock tonight on the news hour. We're going to be looking at it very substantively, very seriously. We couldn't escape it at this hour because news was developing, as you saw, new versions coming up on this story, which people are interested in. I just want to also go across to, I think we have another viewer with us. Imam, I think Sunil from Hyderabad. Yes, Sunil, yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead. Gentlemen,
go ahead, sir.
Let us get back to Nirav Modi. We are getting on the wrong track.
Okay, yeah, sir. I respect your point of view. We've not closed the file on Nirav Modi. Many people will say to us, what is Nirav Modi's crime? There are many apologists already speaking in the media saying that he owed every LOU back and that's why he kept getting new ones. So there's no crime there, nothing's going to come. We've not moved off Nirav Modi. It's an unfortunate development. We were expecting the body back this afternoon. Then we were told that the body was going to be held back because a toxicology report, a forensic examination needs to be done. Then we were told after that it's an accidental death, which raised many eyebrows. Imam Sharif calling in from Hyderabad, the other viewer, and then we were told that, look, the body is now going to be retained further because the public prosecutor is not happy with this forensic report because it's so simplistic, so sketchy, so superficial. Imam Sharif calling in from Hyderabad. Go ahead, sir. Good evening.
First of all, good evening to you. Good evening to all the panelists. You know, before I could comment on this, I just want to say that, you know, with this, we really feel safe that we have a news channel which tries to showcase the truth. I'm really delighted and feel really safe in this country. Second of all, coming to the point, I completely agree with you, all the circumstances that have turned overnight. Now, yesterday, first of all, we were in a shock. We're still in a shock, let's admit that.
True.
And all these conspiracy theories which we are drawing about is only for the fact that we love this individual so much that we really want to get to the bottom of this, and I completely agree with that point as well. However, as Gaurav was saying from the last half an hour, I was trying to say that let's not draw a conclusion. I know that you guys are not trying to draw a conclusion.
Let's all pledge suspicious, but certainly seeking a probe. Because only a probe can get to the bottom of this, and I just hope that probe is not botched. Three theories coming up on your screen. These are the three theories. There is one theory which was pushed very aggressively. Died from accidental drowning in bathtub after cardiac arrest. Cardiac arrest was what was pushed. Now the forensic report said there was no cardiac arrest. Number two, consumed alcohol, couldn't maintain balance, fell, lost consciousness and drowned in the bathtub. That's the other. Many people have come out and said she was not a consumer of hard liquor. There's no way she could have consumed alcohol, got so inebriated that she lost all sense of her whereabouts, tripped, fell and died. Three, lost her balance, slipped, lost consciousness, accidentally drowned in bathtub. This can happen. This can happen. You might slip on a wet patch. In bathrooms, that's known to happen. And she might have fallen. But then the question would be asked, were there any physical injuries on her body? Because if you're falling from a height, you're bound to hit your head, hurt yourself. Those are the pictures coming. First pictures on this channel of the area, the police precinct, where the forensic examination is taking place, where the public prosecutor is meeting with the authorities to get to the bottom of the case. Those are exclusive pictures coming in on Times Now. First view really of the facilities there. It's a late evening, as you can see from the long shadows on the ground, and we will probably be expecting some more news to come through. Simi, I wanted to ask you once again, have you got any updates before I wind up the show? Any updates in the last half an hour or so?
Yes, you know, see, the timing of the cardiac arrest is sometime early evening when Boni Kapoor claimed that she had a cardiac arrest. And
And then from what I'm getting on my messages from my very reliable sources in Dubai and within the industry, he tried to call up Sanjay Gupta and Rajat Raveel, the guy I told you earlier, and he tried to get some help where this could be just passed off as a cardiac arrest.
Okay.
Apparently they could not do that, and that's when this whole theory about the tub and the drowning and everything came about.
Well, now, the body right now is at the police headquarters. That's the building.
All I'm saying is that one glass of alcohol with the antidepressants could have done this to her.
More than meets the eye, says Simi Chandok. We wrap it up. She stays on News Hour with Navika Kumar, where we look at another facet, another interesting facet coming up. Don't go away.